everybody. So the Charnel House Trilogy was recently released on Steam, and I'm here to tell you whether or not it's worth your money. Here are my thoughts.
Developed by Owlcave, the Charnel House Trilogy began its life as a short free-to-play point-and-click adventure game known as Sepulchre, in which a man named Harold rides a reality-bending train with horrifying consequences. With the release of the trilogy, Sepulchre has now been bookended by an introductory prologue that follows a jaded and cynical girl named Alex, and a new and much longer ending chapter which attempts to solve the mystery of the Sepulchre and expand on the narrative introduced in the original game. If it sounds like I'm being vague, you'd be partially correct. The Charnel House Trilogy is an incredibly dense, narrative-heavy story where most of the fun is derived from exploring all of the horrors that await you, as well as uncovering all of the twists and turns that the game presents, especially in the last chapter. It's almost impossible to discuss the plot in great detail without spoiling something crucial to the story. But despite its fairly brief running time of around 2 or so hours, it tells a compelling, thoroughly entertaining psychological horror story that fans of the genre are sure to enjoy. When you first boot up the game and start playing, the influences of classic Sierra and LucasArts point-and-click adventure games of the early 90s should be fairly apparent. Utilizing an old-school pixel art style, it really finds unique and interesting ways to create unnerving and horrific imagery, most of which they accomplish without endless jump scares or excessive amounts of gore. Are both present in the game? Yes, but they don't use them as a crutch. Instead, the game goes for a more subtle approach, which in a lot of ways is much more effective, feeling very reminiscent of games like Clock Tower or Silent Hill. The puzzles are fairly simple, even for relative newcomers to the genre, so you won't have much difficulty getting around, and while personally I wish there would have been a few more difficult challenges, I see that the developers wanted to spend more time telling you a story, rather than try to get you to rack your brain over endless amounts of puzzles. One of the things that really helps accentuate all of the horror elements of the game is the absolutely phenomenal sound design. From the music to the voice acting, it's superb throughout, and definitely the biggest highlight outside of the narrative. All three artists involved with the soundtrack bring a great, atmospheric, eerie tension to each scene, with some of the most suspenseful moments really digging under your skin. The voice acting, likewise, is fantastic, with all except one character being fully voiced for the entirety of the game. Some of the bit parts in the game suffer in the quality department, but both Harold and Alex are handled phenomenally, and a lot of the main side characters, which include media personality Jim Sterling, are amazing as well. Each character brings the proper emotional weight to each scene, and even in the brief moments of levity, it doesn't feel out of place either. In the end, while it's a fairly brief game that doesn't present all that much of a challenge in the gameplay department, the Charnel House Trilogy makes up for a good portion of that with an incredibly well-written and engaging narrative that features phenomenal voice acting and a beautiful atmospheric soundtrack. It probably won't please hardcore adventure game enthusiasts looking for the next big adventure game, but for casual players looking for a fun spooky adventure, I could think of a lot worse ways to spend $5.
So what are your thoughts on the game? Are you a fan of point-and-click adventure games? If so, which one is your favorite? Be sure to leave a comment below letting me know what you think. But as always, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share this video with whoever you want. And until then, I'll see you next time.